Jeffrey Gaines, thanks so much for being here.
All right. Hey, thanks for having me.
Tell us about the song we heard, Falling Apart.
Falling Apart is just, you know, sometimes I never know what I'm going to write. You know, I don't have a preconceived notion. I start out with the music, and then I just develop a melody, and then the words sort of come from things that didn't get an opportunity to be said in real time. You know, things happen in conversation and in life, and you put it away. You know, you put it away, and then ultimately they surface and surprise you with what you've been thinking. And, you know, Falling Apart was just sort of my take on, you know, some of the aspects of humanity and, you know, how tough it is. The animal instinct, you know, just run amok sometimes.
It's certainly a song for our time. What's this world coming to? People losing faith in certain right. time period. Sometimes singer-songwriters don't want to talk about it. They would rather have people interpret it. Do you have a meaning in your heart, or would you rather people just hear it and get their own meaning out of it?
Well, for me, you know, I never try to be, I don't want to be obscure or, you know, over clever. I don't want to do that. I mean, for me, the microphone is used for mass communication. I want to take that opportunity when I have a listener's attention to speak to them and not play around, you know? Because for me, you know, again, being a quiet guy, you know, on stage and in record is generally my opportunity to say what's been on my mind.
You wrote every song on here.
Yes.
I read that you wrote them fairly quickly. Is that typical for you?
No, actually, generally what happens often is, you know, the songwriting process is quick for me, but you have time in between records, and songs sort of happen naturally when they occur, and then you know, maybe, you know, you put out an album and maybe 2 years will go by naturally when you're out touring and stuff. And then by then, next record, you just happen to have them. But this one, I was still on the 2001 release was called Always Be. And I was still out on the road for that when the record company, Artemis, wanted to do the next record. So they surprised me in, let's do another one. So I basically, songwriting is just, again, like I said earlier, things are just in your subconscious all the time. You just have to clear a table. You know, you have to clear the space and just begin, because songs are out there and in you all the time, you know, and it's just a matter of writing it down. It really is.
Talk to me, because we've had a lot of discussions with singer-songwriters in the pop world here about radio and radio play. There was a time in which you weren't getting a lot of radio play, and some DJs were downloading some music, and here I know that's got to be a mixed blessing for a singer-songwriter to have downloading happen, but here they are downloading it and giving you radio play based on that way. Is the downloading kind of thing a mixed blessing for you?
It's been all a blessing, actually. It's been, that was all blessing. That was really great that, you know, PLJ in New York City actually was, you know, putting the thing on. It was a live recording of me singing at a hometown show in Philadelphia, and you know, they put it on the air, and people just calling up, just everybody, anyone and everybody. You know, they were very surprised with the, you know, the span of, you know, they call it the demographic being so vast, you know, little kids, you know, grown people, you know what I mean? Just like different regions and stuff like that. Anybody who could hear it would respond. And so it's been absolutely positive. And if they found it on any of the internet, you know, vehicles or whatever, I mean, really, ultimately, like I said, for me, it's about spreading the word and having the music be heard. If I performed and had a great night that evening, it's recorded, I'm gone to the next place. So anything that happens after the fact, you know what I mean, is even, it's, hey, that's great news to me, you know. So it led to this record being made, so.
Let's let the audience know for certain that you did an unplugged version for us today on the show, but the album is, tell me who else is on the CD and the mix of instruments you have.
Oh, that album, Mitchell Froom and myself produced that out in Hollywood. It was great to, you know, doing a record out in Hollywood. I mean, I usually do albums upstate New York. I've been doing a lot of my projects there, but, you know, flying across the country and spending time in a whole nother environment really, it pretty much influenced everything about it. You know, Mitchell Froom played organ and piano. Matt Chamberlain played drums, John Pierce on bass. Just wonderful guys that I'd never met before. Do you know what I mean? It was like, that's a funny thing. You know, John Paterno recorded the thing. And we did it at the Sunset Sound out there. And it was just, you know, it was a totally new experience. I didn't have any of my guys, you know, any of the players. I just took my guitars and the songs. And I think starting from scratch like that and being very direct and not having a whole lot of conversation other than music talk was probably really respectful, and I should do it again because, you know, just having the universal language of music to speak, just we all got down to work and it sounds like we've been together for a long time. You know what I mean?
Well, you recently played a pretty big place. You did Radio City, shared a stage with Tori Amos. Tell me about that.
First of all, you know, Tori Amos and... I mean, herself and her people, it's a very special situation for a performer. So her audience is, you know, it's pin drop attention and then explosive applause. And you're like, you know, just it sort of taps you on the shoulder and just you have to remind, you know, it reminds you like, man, we really are here for music. And, you know, Radio City, playing that, being on that side of things was such an interesting thing. I've gone to so many shows there. And it's just like, really, it's been a fun year, man. It's just
what's it like looking out and seeing that from the stage? That's a big house.
It's right.
Well, I think we'll all be back at Radio City for the Daytime Emmy Awards. We've been nominated for the first time here on Breakfast with the Arts.
Well,
and so have you. Well, congratulations to you as well. You were nominated for a song you wrote for what?
Actually, it's in All My Thrilled Children. And, you know, the funny thing is it's so not my area. It was just a funny.
You never expected to be part of a soap opera?
Well, I didn't mind it. I didn't mind it, but how much they featured it was really mind-blowing. It was it's a montage where, you know, all the actors are just sort of, you know, reflecting on, you know, the evils, you know, that they're you know, wrapped up in, and, you know, and the song's just like that's the whole thing. It's just wow, for the first time, the songs become the forefront and the stars are in the back. It's very funny. And, you know, it's a song put together with AJ Gundell. And, you know, we'll see what happens. I'm actually just, you know, really honored to be involved. I mean, and, you know, I was talking to some friends about it and they're just like, man, you know, you got a chance, man. I'm like, you know. How long did it take Susan Lucci?
Right? It took her a long time, right.
Don't jinx it, man. Come on, man. You know, you got to get in line.
You mentioned you grew up in PA. You played in bands as a kid. When did it really start for you? Did you sing first? Did you play guitar first? When did it all start?
Well, first. You know what I mean? It's like first. It was always singing, you know? And that goes back to just being, you know, the youngest of three kids in the back of a station wagon, you know, growing up in the 70s or whatever. See, you're singing to the radio, really, you know. A lot of Elton John, you know. Back then, you know, I'm emulating the Jackson 5, you know. And you're capable of it, you know what I mean? It's very funny.
Well, you're capable of it.
My
kids tell me to shut up.
I think really anyone could. It's sort of it's certainly, you know, where, you know, if you can make sound, you know, to speak, if you had begun to train it at a certain point, you know what I mean? It would just be a learned thing. I believe that.
Well, the new CD is called Toward the Sun. Jeffrey Gaines, pleasure to meet you.
Thank you.
Thank you
nice
so much for singing.
Sure.
Jeffrey Gaines' new CD, Toward the Sun, is in stores now.